Hey, 42 here. As you all know, there's a strange species of human called vegetarians. And there's an even more peculiar species called vegans. And for a long time, both groups have begrudgingly been asking the same question. Do plants have feelings? Do they have emotions like us? Do they feel pain? If the answer turns out to be yes, then those aforementioned groups of people are really screwed. And that may very well be the case, because research conducted by forest scientists over a 30-year period revealed that trees have some amazing social skills. Trees can actually talk to each other. And this isn't just basic communication either, they have an impressively large vocabulary. When you walk through the forest, there are hundreds of conversations happening right below your feet. But you won't hear a word, because trees don't communicate via speech, but through electrical impulses, just like the human nervous system. Underneath the soil, a tree's roots spread out horizontally as far wide as the tree is tall, if not more. As they grow sideways, they also intertwine and connect with the roots of all the other trees that surround it. Not only can a tree send electrical signals to its direct neighbours, but by relaying messages from tree to tree, they can talk to each other even if they are many trees apart. This interconnected network of roots is referred to as the Wood Wide Web. In this sense, a forest really is one singular living organism. Even the fungi join in, connecting themselves into the root-based social network, communicating with the trees. So, what could trees possibly be saying to each other? Well, mostly, pass me some food, mate. When trees get low on certain elements which they use to grow, such as carbon, phosphorus, and sulfur, they send a request out into the Wood Wide Web. The closest tree that has some of these elements spare will send the carbon, for example, to the tree that sent the request. And how do they send these nutrients? Well, through the roots, of course. Not only do these magnificent biological superhighways act as a communication network, but they also carry physical elements all around the forest, sharing the resources out equally. Trees even look out for one another. If they notice a particular tree isn't getting enough sunlight, they will slowly reconfigure their branches to let extra light through and pass on more vitamins and nutrients to that tree. Old and sick trees also get extra love and care from their neighbours. They may even choose to disconnect their roots from certain trees if they're not welcome in the community, such as dead, rotten trees. Have you ever noticed how trees seem to copy each other, changing appearance and dropping their leaves around the same time? It's as if they're all perfectly synchronised. Well, that's because they are. Trees also possess the ability to count. They collectively count the passing days and keep track of how many warm days there are throughout the summer and spring each year. They then share this knowledge throughout the forest and use it to open their buds at the optimum time. They do the same thing for the cold days during the winter, so they all know exactly when to start shedding their leaves in preparation for the cold weather. Now, don't worry. As far as we know, it's very unlikely that trees, and any other plants for that matter, can feel pain. They lack the required nerves required to experience the sensation. But they certainly do have personalities. There are good trees that put all their efforts into helping other organisms, and bad trees that steal more nutrients than they really should be doing. It's even been theorized that trees can make decisions and have memories, and they even have wars. Species such as beech and oak are very family orientated and ferociously protect their own. And yes, incredibly, trees do know which trees are their own children. Parent trees will pump sugar solutions through their roots to their children to support their growth. This enables the baby trees to grow up and live a longer life. Family groups will purposely deprive other species growing nearby to try and push them out of their forest. It's practically the ghetto out there. A massive thank you to Audible, who teamed up with me on this video. They are offering everyone watching this video the chance to try Audible free for 30 days. They have an unrivaled selection of audiobooks, original shows, news, comedy, and more. I always put an audiobook on when travelling, it's such an interesting way to pass the time. Audible are offering a free audiobook with your 30-day free trial. Simply go to audible.com/40. Sign up for your free trial, download your first title, and start listening. In preparation for this video, I've been listening to The Hidden Life of Trees by forester Peter Wallaban. It's all about how trees communicate with each other and form their own social network. Now, you may not think a book about trees could be particularly interesting, but I promise you, this one is truly fascinating. Trees just have so many incredible secrets, and they're all inside this audiobook. So, go to audible.com/40 and start listening to it today. You won't regret it. Thanks for watching.